Hi, I'm Greg Scott, and this is the beginning of week four of the four-week challenge I agreed to take on. I'm recording this on a Sunday afternoon, and so the challenge was to record five videos a week for 4 weeks, and I'm recording this one on Sunday afternoon. So this week we're going to do six videos. Today is a bonus. Just because I want to talk about communicating with tech people today. And it's been on my mind. So now maybe I can put it on your mind. A few years ago, a friend of mine had email trouble and she called me and asked me for help. The conversation went something like this. She said, "Greg, my email doesn't work." And I said, "Well, what does that mean, your email doesn't work?" "I can't get into it." "Well, what happens when you try to get into it?" "It doesn't work." "Right, you said that, but what exactly happens?" "I just told you, I can't get into email and I need to check my messages." And she got more and more excited. And I said, "I want to help, but you got to give me more. What email program do you use?" And she said, "Email." I know, but there are lots of email programs. So on your computer, you grab your mouse and you do something to open your email, right? Yeah. "Well, okay, so what do you do?" I swear this is the answer she gave me. She said, "I click on email." Duh. I'm sorry. I still laugh about that conversation. You probably think I made that up, and you probably think there's nobody out there like that. And you probably think that's satire, but it's not satire. It's the truth. I didn't make it up. I was there. Conversations like that go on every single day. My friend figured there's only one email program in the whole world, and since I do for IT for a living, I should be able to rattle off a solution in about 30 seconds so she can get on with her life and make everything all better. That's just kind of how it works. Friends used to call me all the time with tech support questions. They still do, but not as often. When they call, they're usually under stress, and they're in a hurry, and they need me to solve their problem right now because it's life and death. I had one friend who lost 20,000 vacation pictures. Can you imagine that? It was from France, too. They went to France, and now they lost 20,000 vacation pictures from their vacation in France. I had a few late-night calls where school assignments were due the next day, and the next morning, I got to get this done or everything's going to be bad. I had a whole bunch of inaccessible email calls and probably a whole bunch of others I don't even remember. Most of the time, I'm not able to help because I can't even get a good problem description, and this leaves both of us frustrated. Okay, maybe it's a left brain, right brain thing. I forget which side of the brain does what, but I learned if you want to make an artistic person mad, ask a quantity question. How many or how much or what's the process or how did it happen? When did it work? When did it start to act badly? What changed? What was your input and what was the response? Ask a question like that. They'll give you 15 minutes about how all this makes them feel and not one piece of useful information to solve the problem. I know I'm ranting and raving, and I know this goes two ways. I'm an IT guy. I know I fit some of the stereotypes. I don't fit all of them, but I do like Star Trek, and I do think math is cool. And I know I use lots of IT words. I use words like IP address and protocol all the time. They sound important, but that's not why I use them. I use them because I need to use them. I've even been known to lie awake at night and try to figure out what time is. Don't worry. I'm not any closer to figuring out the nature of time than anyone else. Here's the thing. I will try. I'll bust my butt to meet you halfway. We both speak English. You got to move a little bit in my direction, too. Help me help you, and I'll bet we can find lots of common ground. I might even let you help me get in touch with my feelings one of these days. Maybe not. We'll see. Thanks for putting up with me. I think I'm going to go watch a Star Trek rerun now.